Today I'm going to do a review on the Quanxing low angle block tape. This is also known as Luban, it was bought directly from Taobao. Here are some statistics of the plane. The plane's weight is 1 pound 11 ounces. The length from one end to the other end is 6 inch and a half, while the width is 1 inch and 3 quarters. The body is supposed to be made of CR40. It's supposed to be stainless steel. And I tested it with a magnet, it sticks to it. So do expect some care for the body not to rust. The blade is T10, another Chinese tool steel. It took not much time on a sharpen, 5,000 to 8,000 stone to sharpen it up. Here's some attributes of the plane you need to be aware of. The backlash. Backlash is about 3/4 turn, meaning when you extract the blade, you need 3/4 of a turn to engage the blade forward. This is not as bad as some of the low quality block planes, but still it's not up to the standard of Veritas or Lee Nelson. And if you're used to those planes, you'll find there are changes here that you need to adapt to. And next is the plane paint of the body. It's not up to standard. There's already minor chipping and wear, as you can see, if you can see from there, and needs to be addressed over time. So if you get a plane and you expect perfect paint workmanship, you're not gonna find it on this plane. You need to strip the whole thing and then you probably use epoxy paint. For me, just live with it now. Next, and probably one of the most critical features is the flatness of the sole. The flatness of the sole, and this is really a square and straight. I found out that these two sections, the end of the sole and the mouth, is flat. That means it's in parallel, or there are some concavity at this point. It's not critical as the engagement from here to here is the most critical. If there's some concavity here, it doesn't affect the operations of the plane. And then finally, the squareness of the plane. I use this same ruler, which is known to be dead square, against this point and this point. What I found out is that one part of the plane, at least one side, is truly dead square. The others, not really. There's some light between it. So if you expect dead-on machining, then you will definitely be disappointed. But to redeem itself, not the entire thing is all square set. Meaning, this part is square, this part is square, but there is some light coming through it. So overall, when you are doing something on the shooting board, it's pretty flat and square. You probably want to take note when you get your Quanxing plane on that. The thing out of this plane statistics I'm going to cover is the versions of the blade. Seems to be three versions out there in the market over time. So if you bought a plane anything beyond 2013, it'll be version 3. As you can see here, this is a type of profile it has at the back. This is meant for version 3. Version 3 is only meant specifically for Luban. Version 1 and version 2 are compatible with the previous offerings out there like Stanley, Lee Nelson. So be aware that if you buy a Luban plane, you need to find a blade that's compatible to this version 3. If it's out of production, you're going to have a hard time, as I believe Hawk, Veritas and many other manufacturers from the West will not support this plane at all. So here are some statistics that you need to be aware of before I start using this hand plane. I placed a secondary bevel onto this blade itself. It was not there when it was bought. It was sharpened onto 8000 grit sharpened stone. Let's try it out. So this is how I adjust the hand plane. First, I ensure that I'm able to project out the blade as minimal as possible. At this point, I'll disengage this, retract it to the point here, which I'll close it a bit. Look it from the other angle, see how well the blade projects out from the blade. Something that you need to be aware of is its lateral adjustment. You can either move the blade here or here, depending on the blade protruding out at this point. At this point, you need to move it to the left. Let's track the blade again to the point. It's just a hair hanging. Lock it down. Check in. Alright. Next is the mouth. The mouth is quite a lot of gap. I want to close it in. This is how you turn it. You can either engage it, close it here. It's not very smooth, but somewhat acceptable. So let's see how well it performs on this edge here. Okay. Looks like it performs well enough. The shavings produced is fine. As you can see, it could be finer if I project it lower. Let me try. Okay, let's see. This is as low as I can go with my ability. Okay, next try. Looks like it's actually almost thin. Okay, let me try again. Again. So yeah, the shavings produced is really thin, as you can see. So let's do a summary of the plane itself. So here's the main question: will you buy this plane? I would. Will I buy more? I'm not sure. I'll probably have one for this type of plane. As for the other planes, like I can't speak for them for itself, but I'm quite sure I'm not wasting my money if I bought one. Okay, so what's the plus sign? It's price. Price is very attractive compared to the Veritas or even the Linus. Next, it's body material. Claimed to be CR40. Time will tell. As far as I'm concerned, it will rust to me. But to what extent? That's the big question. The next is the blade. The blade is T10. Sounds nice on paper, but it's version 3, so be aware that in the future there could be more versions. And meaning, if the plane machining changes again, your old plane blades for quenching or Luban will not be compatible. So you need to be aware of that too. And next is the paint job, which will probably be the least of my concern. Still, you need to address this one day, sooner or later. I will let time wear it down and I'll just undo it and refinish it with my own paint, preferably with epoxy paint. So I hope I've covered this short review in quite detail as it is. I don't expect it to be the greatest, and I'm sorry if the audio quality is not the best as I'm flaming it outside my house. In due time, I'm going to change location for flaming, and you will have drastic improvement in terms of light, quality, and sound. Wait a minute. So, end this episode. See you then.